Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Jekko and today I'm gonna be talking about Sora. So Sora is this brand new AI thing and it's text-to-video AI thing. It's made by OpenAI, the same people who create ChatGPT and that create Dall-E for image creation. So Sora is text-to-video creation, but it's on a whole new level that world has not seen. So why is Sora so special? Well, with Sora, you can do a bunch of crazy stuff. So look at this. This was purely made in Sora. Now just take a look at it, take a deep look. Like, do you notice anything morphing? Do you notice something looking different than to what they were in the beginning of the video? No, because that's the thing. Sora is like super consistent. And that's like the biggest thing about it. Look at this, look at the elephants, like mammoths. Like, nothing morphs. And that's a fascinating thing. Look at this. Look, this was all created by Sora. And you know what's cool? You can import an image. For example, if you have for your scene, you have this scenario, you can just input an image and it's gonna, you know, make a video like this. Like whatever you type, it's just gonna make it. Another cool thing is the videos can be up to 1080p resolutions. So that's like 1920 times 1080 and or the opposite, 1080 times 1920. And you know, if you wanna, and you can even create images with Sora. Now, why would you create images when you have Midjourney, when you have Dall-E or whatever? Well, there is this one difference. So images can be created in 2048 times 2048 pixels, but one cool thing is, Sora's model is based on videos. And Sora can have a super deep understanding of 3D space. Meaning, if you're trying to create, let's say for example, a video of brick hitting a sofa, you're not gonna have the unexpected result where that sofa, for example, because of the brick hitting it, you're not gonna have the effect that sofa is gonna crack like an egg, it's gonna act like an actual fabric, because all the video training has seen how sofa looking creatures, you know, behave when something interacts with them. And the same goes, you know, for image creation. Whatever you generate, you're like, the whole thing is gonna be infused with heavy logic. Not only that, like if you, for example, see this video, like there's a crowd and just, you know, some festival or something. One thing that AI would always do, you would have like a crowd of people and the people that are further back, they would always look deformed. You know, the one in the front, they would always look logical. But if you take a look here, like everyone seems normal. Like you don't see anything weird happening. You like, if you carefully look at these videos, you are gonna spot, you know, like things that just don't make sense. For example, here, you see these hands here, like a pair of hands, like they appear out of nowhere. There's no head to it. Then the hands goes down and then the same hand is again up and stuff like that. But it's still a little bit crazy. Oh yeah, and for example, you have this grandma that's celebrating her 14th birthday and look where she blows. Look at this. Whew. Dude, you're not even blowing the candles. But yeah, so those are some, you know, logics that are AI related, which we all make fun of. But here is a very, very cool thing that Sora can do. So for example, there is this drone footage and the drone is just passing through some ruins and you can see it like here, etc. It's just going and going. It's nothing special. But what you can do, you can take Sora and tell that, like that footage, to morph into this footage where you see a butterfly swimming in the water. So how on earth are you gonna, you know, morph drone flying through ruins to a deep ocean butterfly swimming kind of thing? Well, you're gonna do it like this. So this is what it did. Look at this. You got a drone, mining, whoop, turned into a butterfly. Look at this, everything just turns blue. And not only that, everything just perfectly blended to the part where that video of the butterfly in the beginning started. And that's the crazy part. So you can blend two different, you can like create five different videos that are doing completely different things. And you can tell Sora that those things blend into the same scenario in the end, and it's gonna look abnormally logical. But the main issue with today's AI is consistency. You know, like creating two identical things is practically mission impossible, and Sora generally, I'm not gonna say it made it possible, but it made a huge step towards it. So take a look at this. You got this little cute ass puppy here, and people are gonna pass through it, and they're just gonna, you know, cover his face, but he's gonna say identical. Look at this. The guy is just not changing. All the freaking spots are in the right places. Not only that, you got this diver who's just minding his own business because, you know, he's swimming near the wreck in the back. And you can extend, like, the environment around him. Look, everything, the reflections, everything was generated by Sora. The stupidest thing is, you can take a random image and he's gonna make a logical video out of that. You can take a video clip, as I said before, a video clip made by Sora and you can extend it, but a real footage. So you have a footage, I don't know, if you're creating a TV commercial or something, you got a real footage and you're missing 5 or 10 seconds of the footage which does not exist, Sora can generate that. Now, can you try this magical piece of software? Absolutely not, because it's not open to the general public, but it will. You can go on the webpage here, OpenAI, and you can read the technical report here of what Sora can do and how it creates stuff. So if you take a look at here, this is like an image of a dog that's just generated as a still image, and this is what Sora created out of him. Look at this. This is... I mean, I have two dogs, and this is a real dog behavior. I mean, just... It looks like a dog, you know, I mean, it does, but it looks like a dog moving. Or yeah, that blending thing, it's crazy. So look at this, you got this footage of, like a city. And then you got this footage of these Christmassy snow figurines. And then you blend those two together. Take a look at this. Look, it's just appearing from the back. I mean, fine, you do see some illogical things happening, but it doesn't look unnatural. Look at this. The hell is even going on? We're just blending a chameleon to this bird. Look at it. It's... Yeah, you know what? It's very cool. I'm really, really curious. You know, like, I even stopped being worried about, you know, AI taking my job or whatever because it's just too exciting for me to worry. And that's kind of my point on it. But yeah, I just wanted to, you know, comment on the whole thing. It's very impressive. You know what? Until AI doesn't produce 16-bit or 32-bit images, or 10-bit videos, I think the industry is safe. Until, I mean, of course, if you're working with 8-bit formats on absolutely everything, for grading or compositing or whatever, you might have a little bit of a shaky ass here, but yeah, I still see this as an inspirational tool. No, it's fascinating. It really is. You know, like the things that you can do with it. You can literally create a video, like, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised, like, if in the near future you can just take, like, old PC games and just run them through the AI filter and you're gonna play, you know, like, Doom 2 or Quake 2 or Duke Nukem and you're gonna just play it looking absolutely photorealistic. It's just that, you know, all the gore scenes where you kill enemies, I think they're gonna look super gross. But yeah, you know what? The whole thing about AI being a filter... You know, like you have those face filters today where you just look artificially pretty. Now, just imagine that you can apply a filter to everything that you do in PC or computer world. No, it's cool. I mean, yeah, it's turbo exciting. You know, I guess see you in the next video. Bye.